Hello learners, in this lecture we will see what is airport master plan and how we need to understand that. So it's a usual practice to start an airport with minimum essential requirements and to go on developing the airport as the demand of air traffic increases, right? So whenever we plan something, initially we'll try to plan something what is required as of now, and as and when it is required we try to expand that. Right now, this is a typical airport master plan what you have, right? You can see it's not that visible, but this is usually what you try to get. So the one which you can see on the right hand side, we call it as a legend. So that means since it's a very big plan, it's very difficult for me to identify. So these are the legends. Let us say this color. Okay, I'll go with this color. This is a blue color. So what is this blue color here? And the same blue color, you can see it somewhere here, let us say. So it will be written, what is that? Let us say there is a river here. So it will indicate that there is a river here, right? Or let us say I'm taking this particular black color. So the black color, what you have here, let us say the terminal building is coming here. So it will be written as terminal buildings. In the same way, each and everything, whatever color you have, they're going to mention what exactly is going to come. So this is a airport master plan usually what we have. So here also you can see where is a runway coming, where is a taxiway coming, where your aircrafts are going to, you know, get parked, where is a terminal building, how many terminals are there, all those things. Even here also you can see the legend. So this legend indicates what exactly this blue color, what exactly this green color indicates. You can see the green color here, the same green color, you can see it here. So it will give us an idea what exactly we have it, right? Yeah. So the main purpose of a master plan is therefore to provide a specific details for the future development of an individual airport to satisfy the aviation requirements. Thus, the master plan takes into consideration the detailed projections of the level of a demand on the various facilities associated with the airport. The master plan shows the ground contours, runways, taxiway, buildings, aprons, control towers, hangars, access road, parking facilities, utilities, and etc. So it's the same thing. This master plan, what I have, no, it shows us everything, that it's like the ground contour, the runways, where is the runway? Okay, the runway is here. In which color it is? It is a gray in color. So that gray in color, you're going to write it here. It's a runway, right? The taxiway, the building, aprons, control towers, each and everything, you're going to find it here. Yeah. So the development of an airport by phase is also clearly marked on the master plan. So this is one of the airport master plan, right? It's written here, Abu Dhabi International Airport master plan, and this is that master plan here. Yeah, right. And this is that company. It's a very big company, Skidmore, Owings and Merrill, right? A construction company it is. So this is a typical, you know, airport master plan what we have. Yeah. Now, according to FAA, that stands for Federal Aviation Administration, which is a regulating agency in the United States. So there are certain objectives of a master plan. So what are those objectives? We'll try to see that. To establish a schedule of priorities and phasing for the various improvements proposed in the plan. To mention the various alternatives considered before finalizing the plan. To present the data and details gathered to develop the plan. To provide an effective graphical representation of the airport together with the anticipated land uses adjacent to the airport. So these are the few objectives of the FAA, and usually they try to ask this in the examination. So you can try to write down these 4 points regarding the objectives of the master plan. Yeah. Now, the other thing is that the FAA, that is the Federal Aviation Administration, has also recommended to prepare the airport master plan in the following 4 phases. There are 4 phases whenever we try to prepare the master plan. So in the phase one, the airport requirements indicating the existing and new facilities with respect to the anticipated demand, environmental implications, and etc. So in the phase two, site selection, evaluating the available sites and analyzing with respect to the various factors governing the airport site selection. And in the phase three, airport plan showing overall layout, the land use, the terminal area, access routes, each and everything. This you're going to do it in the phase three. And the phase four is the financial plans showing the economic feasibility of a plan, development cost, financial feasible analysis, schedule showing stages of development with respect to the availability of the funds and etc. So again, these are the 4 phases usually when we try to do the master plan. And these are the things that we need to follow. Yeah. So I hope you have got an idea about the master plan, how it has to be understood, how a master plan looks, what all things will be given in the master plan, right from the runway to the taxiway to the terminal buildings, each and everything will be given there. And also the FAA, FAA, that is Federal Aviation Administration, has four objectives, and we have understood those four objectives. And whenever we try to do the airport master plan, these are the four phases what we have, the phase one, phase two, and phase three. Based on that, we try to carry out the master plan of an airport. So we'll see you back in the next lecture. Thank you.